the Berlin Wall, part of the Iron Curtain that cut Europe.
Yeah, that is just beautiful. Thank you, sir.
I don't know. I'm kind of an emotional sort of person anyway. I cry too easily. I did then. I do now. And I had tears in my eyes when I was given this symbol of the end of the Cold War.
On his Wyoming ranch, James Baker, Bush's Secretary of State, discovered a real friendship for Eduard Shevardnadze, the Soviet foreign minister.
Excuse me, I'm from the Park Service. Do you guys have a fishing license?
Absolutely.
The police tried to stop them. But the government was losing its nerve.
Kein Wort dafür. Sprach.
In short, we were speechless because we were helpless.
Hilflosigkeit. Weil dieses Land,
because this country
und diese Führung
and this leadership
nie erlebt
had never before experienced a conflict
eine Konfliktsituation,
which was so openly expressed.
Dartun konnte.
Only Honecker seemed to notice nothing amiss. On the eve of East Germany's 40th anniversary that October, he was confident as he waited with his colleague Egon Krenz to greet his senior guest, Mikhail Gorbachev. The Soviet delegation already knew that the East German regime was tottering.
The regime was doomed.
Es war.
This was a vote of no confidence against us.
Then,
Gorby-Gorby did not mean do it exactly as it was done in the Soviet Union. Gorby-Gorby meant we need change here in the GDR.
In a series of increasingly surreal meetings, Gorbachev tried to inject a sense of reality.
Honecker and I spent about 3 hours talking. He couldn't understand why I wanted a meeting. But we had a serious discussion. I told him what we were doing. He told me what they were doing. He described it all as one victory after another. But I said, he who lags behind events loses.
It was absolutely clear to me that both sides spoke about two completely different things. They did not try to meet in the middle. During the whole conversation, they did not agree on a single thing.
As the leaders met at the closing reception, a plot was hatching against Erich Honecker. A group in the East German Politburo had decided to try and get rid of him.
We could no longer afford to hesitate in removing Honecker. We had to act fast.
Und daraus konnte man entnehmen, dass er.
charged and scattered the demonstrators. But an even larger protest rally was called for 2 days later. The army was on standby.
They realized that they could no longer control the events with the police alone. They wanted to use us to increase the pressure on the situation.
Almost all paramilitary brigades were mobilized. The voluntary police force were out in strength. More than 8,000 men were armed and sent with their equipment to Leipzig.
We were issued with twice as much ammunition as normal. Usually we had 60 rounds. Now they gave us 120 rounds.
One of us had a friend at the hospital, and he'd heard that blood reserves had been ordered and spare beds were to be kept free on that day. The city was in a state of emergency. Shops had to close at 5 o'clock. We felt very intimidated. At work, people warned each other, don't go into town tonight. Who knows what's going to happen?
As the Leipzig demonstration moved off, the local Communist Party leaders realized that 70,000 people were already on the streets. Alarmed, the Soviet ambassador telephoned the commander of Soviet forces in the region.
Я прошу